summer's day in May. What is love? What is love? I just want it to be loved. Oh, oh, and I can feel it in your kiss. It just gives me tender bliss. What is love? What is love? I just want it to be loved.
Thank you. You may be seated. Isn't God good giving us such a beautiful evening like this? And what a special time this is. We are thrilled to be here, aren't we? And we are in this beautiful place for a very beautiful purpose. And that is to join Jason and Katie in holy matrimony. And in a very special way give honor and glory to their God, our God and Savior, Jesus Christ. This is indeed a holy and sacred moment, for we believe that God has brought these two together and that they have discovered that it is God's will for them to be united in His ordinance of marriage. The Bible teaches that marriage is to be a permanent relationship between one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. Jason and Katie stand here in the presence of their Lord to commit to each other their love. And they are indeed grateful for your presence as they pledge their lifetime love to each other. Jason and Katie both believe Jesus to be their Savior and Lord. They are already united in Christ as believers. They both have put their trust and faith in Jesus, so they are bound together in love for Him. Now that bond takes on a new and beautiful dimension through the covenant of marriage. Jason and Katie, you are here signifying your desire to be united in marriage. Jason, is it your desire to have Katie to be your wedded wife?
Yes.
Katie, is it your desire to have Jason to be your wedded husband? Who then gives this woman to be married to this man? Jason and Katie, Christian marriage is serious because it will bind you together until death separates you. It will bind you in a relationship so close and so intimate that the two of you will become one. As you know, marriage is a commitment, and you are here in the presence of your God and your family and friends to make that commitment to each other and to God. Before you lies a wonderful future with its hopes and its disappointments, its successes and failures, its pleasures and pains, its joys and sorrows. And these are all part of everyday life and are to be expected. But for Christians, they are not to be received with defeat, but with hope and joy and with all the spiritual resources that God promises us. And of course, the great resource that God gives us is His precious love. The Bible says, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. And it always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes, and it always perseveres. This kind of love that God gives us never fails. As we come to a special time when you promise and pledge your love for each other, remember that there is not another moment in life filled with more hope and more joy and more commitment than this sacred moment. This moment is always to be cherished and remembered. The vows you are about to make will be locked in your memories as a reminder that you have pledged to love for a lifetime the one who stands beside you. Through the years, your remembrance of this moment is intended to strengthen your marriage and to cause you to give thanks to God for having each other. Jason and Katie, what you promise now must be renewed each day of your lives, for real love is something beyond the warmth and the glow and the excitement and the romance of being deeply in love. It is caring more for the welfare and happiness of your spouse than it is your own. It is loving each other with the kind of love that God has for us. The Bible says, therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. And husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church, which is His bride, and gave Himself for it. Here you are establishing a Christian marriage where the Lord Jesus Christ is the head of your home and the object of your deepest affection. And He will confirm your marriage by His guidance, and He will protect it with His peace. Now, Jason and Katie, understand that God will hold you responsible for the commitment you are making today. And this commitment means that you will honor and support each other, protect and provide for each other, submit and be faithful to each other, so long as you both shall live. If you two come having this real desire to be united in the permanent bonds of abiding wedlock, would you please signify by joining your right hands? Jason, will you take Katie to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? And will you love her, comfort her, honor her, keep her, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Katie, will you have Jason to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? And will you love him and comfort him and honor him and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Okay. Jason, now please repeat these words after me if they are the desire of your heart.
I, Jason, take you, Katie,
to be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part. And to you I pledge my faithfulness. Katie, would you please repeat these words after me if they are the desire of your heart? I, Katie, take you, Jason, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better. For worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
And to you I pledge my faithfulness. In the spirit of this love that you have for each other, you will be signifying your relationship by exchanging rings. Rings are the outward visible sign of your invisible commitment, that commitment that you're making to the Lord and to each other. And as you exchange these rings, be aware of how they betray the ideal marriage. The circle with no beginning and end represents wholeness, and the gold signifies purity in your relationship. Jason, please place this ring on the proper finger and repeat after me. Katie, with this ring, I give my love.
Katie, with this ring, I give my love.
And everything I have, I share with you.
And everything I have.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Now, Katie, will you receive this ring as a token of Jason's love for you, and will you wear it as a token of your love for him? Katie, please place this ring on the proper finger and repeat after me. Jason, with this ring, I give you my love.
Jason, with this ring, I give you my love.
And everything I have, I share with you.
And everything I have, I share with you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now, Jason, will you receive this ring as a token of Katie's love for you, and will you wear it as a token of your love for her?
I will.
As a testimony of their faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, Jason and Katie have chosen as their first act of marriage to receive communion. The Lord's Supper is an ordinance of the church and is intended to be for believers. So Jason and Katie testify by partaking of the Lord's Supper that Jesus Christ is their Lord and Savior, and that they desire for Jesus to be in the very center of their marriage. Jason and Katie, it is a commitment and a commandment of Jesus Himself that we should observe communion until He comes. By partaking of the Lord's Supper together on this special occasion, you are not only joining your lives to one another, but you are recognizing the need and the responsibility of giving Jesus Christ first place in your marriage and in your family and in your lives. The bread is a symbol of the broken body of our Lord when He hung and died on the cross at Calvary for us. We must never forget what Jesus did for us. We must never forget that He died for us. We must never forget the price that He paid so that we might be saved. Our Lord commanded us to do this in remembrance of Him. Now please, both of you, eat the bread. The cup is a symbol of the blood that Jesus Christ shed on the cross for the remission and the forgiveness of sins. In this cup, there is a reminder that there is a gift, and it is called grace. And no matter how hard you try, you can never wash away your own sin. What can wash away our sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Our Lord commanded us to do this in remembrance of Him. Now please, drink the cup. Jason and Katie, you will now light the unity candle, signifying that you are no longer two, but one. These two candles represent your lives in this moment. And as you now join together in marriage, there is a merging of these two lights into one light. And this is what our Lord meant when He said, "On this account shall a man leave his father and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." Now please light the candle. Now let's pray. Father, thank You for this special, special time. God, thank You for such beautiful weather. We are thrilled to be here to witness Jason and Katie becoming husband and wife. We join our hearts together to pray for them as they dedicate themselves together and to You, God, this special evening. I pray that the love between them will grow stronger and sweeter each day. May they always trust each other, and in perfect confidence, may they trust in You, God. May they continue to grow closer to You and to each other, and may You continue to use them to touch the lives of others. And God, bestow on them the gift of children and the grace to bring them up to know, to love, and to serve You. I pray that Jesus Christ will always be acknowledged as their Lord. Now crown their marriage with Your grace and Your love and Your faithfulness, now as long as they both shall live. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Jason and Katie, you have made a commitment in the presence of God. May you find strength and peace in each other, and may your love for Jesus and each other be strengthened and reaffirmed each day of your lives together. The Bible says the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace. As you have solemnly agreed before God and these witnesses, having pledged your love for one another and having sealed the holy vows of matrimony by the giving and the receiving of these rings, by the power invested in me by God, I joyfully pronounce you as husband and wife. The two have become one. What God hath joined together, let no one tear apart. Now, Jason, you may kiss your bride. Now it is my joy to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jason Forsythe.